So, sir, please go on, sir.
Sir, before commencing security management, I have two things left. One is SQL injection, another one is phishing. After completing these two,
and he also rage quit a lot. That is bad for my mental.
Okay, sir, continue.
Before going to security management, right now I am starting SQL injection. SQL injection. SQL injection. Yes. Everybody listen, sir?
Yes, sir, audible.
SQL injection is a code of injection techniques which attacks data-driven applications in which malicious SQL statements are inserted into it and executed. For a given example of SQL injection, suppose some private information are known to every public. For example, in an organization, student name, student registration number, these are publicly available to everyone. Suppose someone wants to the date of birth of a particular student. In that case, SQL injection is somehow helpful. It means by knowing the name of the student and registration of the number of the student, you have to establish a clause by giving a instruction to the database to fetch the date of birth of the particular student. If there is a vulnerability of the database, the SQL injection is possible. Otherwise, it is not possible. For that reason, SQL injections filters the lateral escape characters embedded in SQL statements, strongly type unexpected executed. It means SQL injections is mostly known as the attack vector for websites, but can be used to attack any type of SQL databases. I will give you some real example of SQL injection. There are some simple steps to check the SQL vulnerability in a website. You can check websites. You can use the web pongspider.hyperignorancy.com to find the SQL vulnerability of a website. This is one way. The other way is to
Excuse me, Sudhir sir, is there any presentation you are also making?
Sir, presentation means your only book I have.
Oh, we were expecting some PPT presentation for it would have been much easier for us. Anyway, if you are not prepared, please continue.
I can give you the PPT within 2 to 3 hours after the class. No problem. Only two things are important. One is SQL injection, another one is phishing. I have left the next class. These two I have explained first, then we'll go for the next chapter, security management. Second step, you can insert a colon at the end of any URL. Suppose you are typing insert a colon in the any URL at the end of the URL to find the SQL vulnerability of the website. If is there any vulnerability in the website, then you can check it also. You can use Google Doc to find the SQL injection vulnerability also. There is a tool, Google Doc, to find the SQL injection vulnerability. If the vulnerability is there, then you'll go for the SQL injection. This is the very vital things to know a hackers. Like that phishing. Phishing is the attempt to acquire sensitive information such as user's name, password, credit card details, sometimes directly or indirectly, how many money present in the account also done by the way of phishing also. Phishing is one type of electronics communication. It means you can create a similar website like the government registered website by the help of a tool, HTTrack. HTTrack is normally helpful to create a similar blueprint of the website by using a software. It is known as HTTrack. It can copy the entire source code to create a similar website. By the help of phishing, You can phishing is all, otherwise also known as a social attack. Social attack. It is very much helpful in Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus. Hackers can create a clone of the website, and this clone is forwarded by as a link to the particular person. When the person clicks the link, then indirectly the entire information is phished to the hackers. Now, how this can be hacked? There are, in normal practical ways, we are using five different techniques. Hackers buy a small, buy a mail domain, mostly matching with the government registered domain. This is a one process of phishing. Next, they create a phishing page by creating a blueprint of the website by using software called HTTrack. HTTrack is a software. They can create a blueprint of any government software. To copy the website, then modify the source code a bit. Third step, buy a top-level domain to match with government website and host it along with a SSL to it, and upload the source code to the phishing page, to the public folders in the admin panel, public folder to the admin panel. Any persons when click on the information, by that time the entire details will be phished. Fourth step, after this, they send a phishing link to the victim with a fake mail. By a fake mail, the attacker send a phishing link to the victims. Fifth step, then the victim falls to the trap thinking that it is a registered mail. This is the steps to follow by to phish the details by the way of phishing. Then I'll discuss very important thing. One is program threats, another one is system threats. Normally, two type of threats are happening in the ethical hacking. One is program threats, another one is system threats. System threats means worms, port scanning, denial of service. Normally, these are the system threats. Programming threats means you are preparing some programs like Trojan horse, such a small program we can create the login credentials. Trapdoors, logic bombs, virus, these are the program threats. Every hackers must be known the two things. One is program threats, another one is system threats. Program threats means operating system process and kernel do the designated task as the instructed. If a user program made this process as to do malicious tasks, then it is known as a program threats. Examples of the program threats are Trojan horse, trapdoors, logic bombs, and viruses. Normally, you are using logic bombs is a situation when a program misbehaves only when certain conditions meet otherwise. It works as a genuine program. It is harder to detect. It means when you click on the attachment or any link given to them, then the trap, then the every details must be trapped by the hackers. Then Trojan horse. Such programs trap user login credential and stores them to send a malicious user who can later on log into the computer and can access the system resources. This is a one type of program threats. Then you go for the virus. Virus, as the name suggests, it can be replicated themselves on the computer system. They are highly dangerous and can modify or delete user files also. Crash systems. A virus is generally a small code embedded in a program. As user access the program, the virus starts getting embedded to other files or programs and can make system unusable for the users. These are the mainly used for the program threats. Then we go for the system threats means coming days I can also discuss. There are three type of system threats are available. One is worm, another is port scanning, third one is denial of service. Worm is a process which can choke down a system performance by using system resource to extreme levels. A worm process generates multiple copies where each copy is used system resources. prevent all other processes to get required resources. ORM process can even shut down the entire network, and ORM can be replicated by itself. ORM is much more harmful than virus. Virus is a program threat, but ORM is a system threat. Then port scanning. Port scanning is a mechanism or by the help of port scanning, which hackers can detect the system vulnerability to make an attack on the system. Then you go for the denial of service. Denial of service attacks normally prevent users to make legitimate use of the system. Use of internet, use of any other devices, browsers, by the help of denial of service attacks are very much useful. These are mainly the program threats and system threats. Then we go for the, as for the today's topic, security management. Normally, in case of security management, a disaster recovery plan is documented process to set for the recovery. Disaster recovery plan means, while in a software development environment, normally we are using some models, suppose we are using a lifecycle model, means this model consists of starting from feasibility study to ending with maintenance. In between, disaster management policy is also a plan. It means the first step is feasibility study. Feasibility study is a process where we can interact with the customer only by different meaning, by asking some questions, by giving some literally documents, or by some questionnaires methods also, they can be helpful to allow feasibility study. After feasibility study is over, we can identify the customer. Feasibility study's main aim is to basically identify the three things. One is technical feasibility, operational feasibility, as well as financial feasibility. Then physical study is over. Based on the three things, then we go for the next stage of the lifecycle development process. It means software requirement specification. Then we go for the design. After design, then we go for the coding. Based on the coding, we go for the unit testing. After unit testing and coding is over, then every modules are slowly integrated and the integration and system testing phase starts on. After integration and system testing process is over, then you go for the plan, disaster recovery plan. It means any mistake by any vulnerability is present in the writing the code, it can be being managed. Why these things are happening in IT industry means, normally IT products are intangible in nature and invisible in nature. To measure the proceeds of the softwares, we can use these plans also. In disaster recovery plans, we can check some things. One is avoid failures, how failures can be managed safely, failure recovery and disaster recovery. Four things we can done in disaster recovery plans. Benefits of disaster recovery. Then we discuss the benefits of the disaster recovery. Providing a sense of security, minimizing risk of delays, guaranteeing the reliability of standby systems, providing a standard for testing and plans, minimizing decision making during a disaster, reducing potential legal liabilities, lowering unnecessary stressful work environment. These are the main way of disaster recovery procedures. We can classify the disasters into three different situations. One is natural disaster. Normally everybody knows this can be happened by the nature also, natural disaster. The second one is man-made disasters. In case of man-made disasters, we can go for the plans. In business resumption plans, occupants emergency plans, contingency operation plans, incident management plans, and disaster recovery plans. These are the five plans normally you can done in the business organizations. Like that, in IT industry, we can go for the risk also. in IT industry, you can like disaster recovery, we can use in risk also. There are several risk factors in the IT related to the IT industries. What are the disaster control mechanism, the control recovery mechanism used in the industries? First method is preventive measures. Preventive measures mainly based on the an event from occurring. It is prevented the event before occurring is known as the preventive measures. Likewise, you are using antiviruses is also a preventive measures. Detecting measures means control aimed at detecting or discovering unwanted events. If any unwanted events are happening, before that, if it is being detected, it is known as detective measures. Third one is corrective measures. Corrective measures means control aimed at correcting or restoring the system after a disaster of an event. These are the three measures. One is preventive measures, defective measures, as well as corrective measures used for disaster recovery plans. Like that in IT industry also, we can use similar kind of plans. Similar kind of plans in IT industry. This is means here you are using preventive, detective and corrective measures. In IT industry, you are using perfective, adaptive measurement also. Perfective means if some definite changes is required to attend the requirement of the customer, this is known as a perfective. Corrective and adaptive methods are also used in IT industries. Then you go for the testing, testing and the plans. As I told you the details, testing, when testing is being happened, after coding a particular software, then you go for the testing. Normally, testings are of two types in industry. One is basically testing done by the developer and testing done by the tester. Testing done by the developer means normally this type of testing are unit testing. Unit testing normally done by the developer itself. While writing the code, every developer must be compile the code and test the source code also. This type of testing is normally done by the developer. This is known as unit testing in industry. Unit testings are of two types. One is black box testing, another is white box testing. In black box testing, only the existing codes has to be checked for the standard inputs and standard outputs only. It means the developer only check to accept the standard inputs, and what is the standard output or standard results is coming or not is checked by the unit testing. This is type of testing is known as black box testing. Every industries are also done by black box testing also. Here also black box testing are useful. Then you go for the white box testing. White box testing means the code knowledge. The tester has some certified code knowledge. Then you accept the testing. It means the criteria of white box testing are only based on the code knowledge. For example, equivalence class partitioning is a white box testing example. Suppose a database is there. A database has accepted 1,000 data values. So what will happen after 1,001 or after 1,002? It can be checked by the white box testing in cases. But in disaster recovery plans, we can test checklist test, full interruption test, and parallel test. And simultaneous test. These are the four type of testing normally done in the disaster recovery planning criteria. Normally testing criteria are based on the feasibility and compatibility of backup facilities and procedures, identifies areas in the plan that needs to be modification, providing training to the team managers and team members, demonstrating the ability of the organization to recover, providing motivation and maintaining and updating the disaster recovery plans. These are the main criteria, the procedures to prepare the test plans. And different type of test means what type of testing normally are done here: checklist test, full interruption test, full interruption test, parallel test, simultaneous test. These are the main disaster recovery plans. Then we go for the digital signature. But this is a very vast area right now. Digital signature, digital signature certification. Everybody knows signature means you have to, if something is written in the front, then if you go for a direct signature by applying signature, it means you can accept the entire procedure. Then you go for your oath, take your oath. This is known as signature works. How the signature works. Similarly, digital signature also works in like this. But in case of digital signature, there are several things must be matched for a particular person. Then you go for a signature. This is a combination of some data along with some real applications. It means you have to paste the name, date of birth, anything you can paste in a single window. Then you go for a particular OTP. If the OTP is matched with a real application, then the digital signature is accepted. This is the procedure. Digital signature is a mathematical scheme for demonstrating the authenticity of digital message or document. It means a valid digital signature gives a reason to believe that message has created by a known sender. It means authentication already done. Then the sender cannot be denied having sent the message, means non-repudiation. The message is already authenticated, means the sender must be identified and the message has not altered in transit. But the integrity of the message is accepted. Digital signature is the electronic equivalent of a handwritten signature, verifying the authenticity of electronic document. In fact, digital signature provide even more security than their handwritten counterparts. It means some banks, package delivery companies, use a system for electronic recording handwritten signatures. Some even go for the biometrics analysis of the records, which can be also the example of a digital signature. Then you go for the application of digital signature. Normally, digital signature are the public key primitives of message authentications. In the physical world, it is common to use handwritten signature on the handwritten or typed message. They are used to blind signature to the message also. Similarly, digital signature is a technique that binds a person or entity to the digital data. The binding can be independently verified by receivers as well as the third party also. It means when you put a digital signature, means the resources can fetch your name, your date of birth, also fetch your mobile number, email address. But while authenticating, means they have given a certain link or certain code, you have to authenticate it by the process of your email or by process of your OTP also. Then you go for the mechanism of digital signature. As I have discussed, these are the procedures to create a digital signature. So in case of digital signature, messages.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, one question from one student. Okay. That is the authorized of digital signature? Who is the authorization of digital signature?
Who gives the authorization of the digital signature?
Digital signature.
The person is also authorized along with the system. Oh. Along with the system, the particular person is also authorized. For example, suppose OTP is given to a particular phone. This phone is also maintained in the record also. If the simultaneous OTP is matched, then the person is authorized. Digital signature always takes two things. One is real world application, another one is the normal application. Normal application means the client pays the name, address. These are the normally faced by the client, and the date of birth, it should be matched. But Aadhaar number, Aadhaar OTP, then mobile OTP, this is the real-time application. When the digital signature comes for an application, at that time, the OTP will send to the particular person. If the OTP is matched, means the digital signature is void. If the OTP does not match, means this digital signature is nullified. It is not work properly.
Okay, sir, continue. Thank you.
Digital signature means digital signature mechanism follows some encryption and decryption of data. It means sender sends signed message. The best example is Odisha government is using by creating your residential certificate, your income certificate. By that process, they are using digital signature also. It means when a person wants his document, he can forward a message. This message is verified by the particular officer. Then the officer put a digital sign. It means all the documents produced by the users is right on that stage. After verification, the receiver will get the certificate. This is a one way of digital signature process. In digital signature, sender signed message along with the public key. The public key will be given to the receiver by the method of hash function. After matching the public key, then the sender and receivers are perfectly paced by itself. It means when we put a normal sign means we have to read all the document and put a sign. By the similar way, in case of digital signature, you also read the entire document and put a sign by the way of digital information. It means it can keep your photograph, keep your original signature also, but it can be valid by a certain process. But this process being done by a real-time application. It means they have given a OTP to your email ID or given a OTP to your phone. These two things are when matched, then the signature is valid.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir, in your book, page number 22, they have given a process of digital signature and what is the way they can be verified. In the left side, they have keep the signature side, and the right side, they have put the verified side. Signature side, data, hashing function, hash values, signatures, private key, and signature algorithms are maintained. Signature side. The verified side, hashing function, data, signature, verification algorithm, equal values, and hash values are also maintained. When entire solution is matched, means digital signature is worked. Please go through the page number 22. In case any doubt, you can ask me no problem. Then the importance of digital signature means message authentication is also a best example of digital signature. Data integrity, non-repudiation. These are the main importance of digital signature. It means message authentication means when a verifier valid the digital signature using a public key of a sender, he is assured that the signature has been created only by a sender who passes the corresponding secret private key on no one else. It means when the OTP comes from a particular phone, this OTP is matched means the signature is authenticated. When the OTP comes from other sources, it cannot be matched. Then we go for the data integrity in case of digital signature. In case of data integrity, attacker has access to the data and modify it. Somewhere it is possible. The digital signature verification at receiver end fails. The hash or modified data and the output provided by the verification algorithm will not match. In that case, data integrity happens. It means the receiver can safely deny the message, assuming the data integrity has been breached. It means the data is somewhere taken by other else. Then you go for the non-repudiation. Since it is assumed that only the signer has the knowledge of the signature key, he can only create unique signature on the given data. Thus, the receiver can present data and the digital signature to a third party has evidence. If any dispute arises, then the data repudiation fails. These are the ways normally you are using digital signatures. Applications, similar application authentication, integrity, and data repudiations are normally used for digital signature. in case of digital signature, encryption with digital signature is also possible. It means someone, if someone adds, want to add, add his iris, face marks, thumb impression, any pictures also add to the digital signature, it is matched. It means encryption of digital signature is allowed also. It means sender gives the encrypted data to the receiver along with the public key, then the encryption data along with public key treated as a hashing function. After the hash value is encashed, then the digital signature with private key are displayed. This is the total process of creating the digital signature by the method of encryption. It means suppose someone add to its thumb impression. The thumb impression is directly does not go to the go to the sender side. It will be a fast hashing, fast encrypted by a public key. The encrypted message treated as a hash function, then the hash function is converted to digital signature with sender's private key. As compared digital signature to electronic signature, in electronic signature, normally in electronic digital signature within a public key infrastructure is treated as a electronic signature. It means biometric devices, PINs, passwords, scanned handwritten signatures, signature by digital pen, some radio clicks, accept, okay, I agree, checkboxes is also helpful to creating the electronic signature by the help of digital signature. Normally when we are going for a form fill up or anything, then we check checkable, check okay or I accept or I agree on the click box. This is also helpful for digital signature. Or signature by a digital panel, scanned handwritten signatures, passwords, PINs, biometric devices, digital signature within a public key infrastructure. These are mainly based on the digital signature to electronic signature. For preparing digital signature, we have to use some algorithm, digital signature algorithm. RSA, DSA, these are the mainly used for digital signature algorithm. Basically, algorithms are need to convert the A to, suppose someone wants A is converted to D as well as B is converted to E. In that case, they have to prepare a function. It means every value comes, it will be added by 3 and divide, take the module value of 26. Then it will be converted to a formula. By that case, some digital signatures are created based on the some algorithm schemes. Normally, you are using some algorithms, Robin signature algorithm, pairing based schemes, aggregate signature schemes, signature with efficient protocols. These are used for general digital signature cases. The legal part of the digital signature, then we go for the legal part of the digital signature. All digital signature schemes shares basic prerequisite regardless of this cryptographic theory of legal provision. It means quality algorithms, quality implementation, private key must remain private. These are the main techniques used for digital signature checking. Normally, digital signature are very much useful in case of credit card acceptance. It means some digital certificate is an electronic document, established document. While you are using credit cards, they are using the, your credentials by the help of digital signatures. It means digital signature, DSC, are the digital equivalent of a physical or paper certificate. Digital signatures policies. In IT Act 2020, digital signatures based on asymptotic encryption techniques, the digital signature are now accepted as per the handwritten signature as per the IT Act 2000. Who needs digital certificates? Any authorization persons always needs digital certificates. It means your directors, auditors, company secretaries, bank officials and other authorized signatories are normally converted to a digital signature component. Then type of digital signature. Normally we classify the digital signature into three types, class 1, class 2 and class 3. Based on your preparation, it can be classified. Class 1, in case of class 1 means, normally in the class 1s are used for in licensing authorities, they are using class 1. For class 2 and 3, normally used in any banking transaction, credit card transaction, they are used the class 2, 3 type of digital certificates. Any doubt in digital signature or digital signature use, sir?
No, sir. At the end, if any question we'll ask, then we'll discuss it.
Okay. Okay. Then we go for the pen testing. Pen testing. Pen testing is a part of ethical hacking or penetration testing. When a pen testing is performed, it is typically take one of the three values, three forms. It means pen testing are of white box, gray box, and black box. Normally, pen testings are of three types. One is black box, gray box, and white box. Black box means, as the name suggests, a type of testing which the pen tester has a little or no knowledge of the target. As I says, in case of software engineering also, in black box testing means the tester has a little bit knowledge regarding the code. Tester only check the standard inputs and check the standard output also. In ethical hacking, they are using black box testing, a type of testing in which the pen tester has little or no knowledge of the target. This situation is designed to closely illuminate the situation an actual attacker would encounter, as they would have extremely low level of knowledge of the target is going on. It means he has only to browse the system and go for the any threats available or not. This is known as black box testing. In case of gray box testing, it's the form of testing where the knowledge given to the testing party is limited. In this type of test, tester acquires knowledge such as IP address, IP address, operating system, network environment. Information is limited. In this type of ethical hacking, normally gray box hacking, they can trace the IP addresses, operating system, and network environment. But the information is limited. This type of test to closely illuminate the type of knowledge that someone's on the someone's inside the source. Such a person would have some knowledge and of a target, but not always it works. It means it differs from operating system to operating system. If the hackers has certain knowledge, it can be check the IP address, the operating system details, and networking environment details also. Then you go for white box. White box is a form of testing in which the information given by the tester is complete. This means the pen tester given all information about the target system. Before going to the testing, the tester has certain knowledge fully knowledge about the system. This type of testing typically done internally by the team that performs internal audit of the system. These are the three types of pen testing normally available in the for the hackers. Three things are very much essential for a hacker. One is confidentiality, integrity, and availability. It is combinedly called as CIA. Confidentiality, integrity, and availability must be known to the hackers. Confidentiality means the core of principles. The core principles that refers to the safeguarding of information and keeping it away from those not authorized to possess it. Example of control, preservative confidentiality, that are permissions are encrypted. Integrity means integrity deals with keeping information in a format, keeping information in a format that is true and correct to the original purpose. Meaning that the data that the receivers access is the data the creator intended to them. This is known as the integrity. It means the hackers, the data present with the receivers and the senders, both are checked, both are correct. Then the availability. The final and possible one of the most important item that you can perform availability deals with keeping information and resources available to those who needs to use it. Who needs to use it. Information or resources, no matter how safe and sound, are only useful. They are available when called upon. This is the main possible of CIA is a possible, the most important set of goals to preserve when you are accessing and planning security for a system. How to break the CIA? How to break the confidentiality, integrity, and availability? This is also done by three ways: disclosure, alteration, and disruption. Disclosure means is the accidental or malicious revealing, accessing information of the resources by the outside party is known as the process of disclosure. If you are not supposed to have access to an object, you should never have access to it. It means if you do not know the confidentiality or integrity or availability of the resource, you never disclose the object. Then alteration. Alteration is the counter to integrity. It deals with the unauthorized or can be corruption, accidental access, or malicious in nature. Then we go to disruption. Disruption is otherwise known as a loss. Loss. It means that access to the information resources has been lost when it should not have. Information is useless. It is not there in the need. Although information or resources can be 100% available. This is known as the process of disruption. Then in which process normally go for a pen test? Why did the client request a pen test? There are several associated tasks are necessary for a hacker to know regarding the pen test. This means, why did the client request a pen test? This is the first question. What is the function or mission to the organization to be tested? This must be known by hackers. What will be the constraint or rules? The rules of engagement of the test. What is the data? Who is the data owner? It must be tested. What are the expected costs? What are the resources will be available? What are the things to be modified? This must be known by the hacker also. Along with several conditions must be known by the hacker. What condition will determine the success of the test? Who will be the emergency contact? This must be known by the hacker also. An outsider attack is intended to mimic those actions that attacks were undertaken by the outside party. This must be known by the pen tester. Pen testing can take several forms. You must decide along with your client before tempering client which tests are appropriate and will while the desired result, then it must be tested. Then we go for the hacking. What is the meaning of hacking? Hacking is a technical effort to manipulate the normal behavior of the network connections and connected computer systems. A hacker is any person engaged in hacking. A hacker is any person engaged in hacking. This is the basic definition of hacking. Then we go for the culture of hacking. Culture of hacking means to accept as a hacker, one should have the following attitudes. It means strong zeal, learn to obtain more knowledge regarding the system, breaking law, and anonymity is the main required and stealing confidential information. These are the two things required for a hacker. So basing on this, we have to distinguish the types of hackers. One is white hat, black hat, gray hat, then suicide hackers, script kiddies, and hacktivist. These are the mainly six types of hackers normally exist in ethical hacking. These are the types based on the knowledge and attitude of the ethical hacker. White hat hacking means white hat are the good guys. Normally in ethical hacking, white hat are the good guys. The ethical hackers who use hacking skills for defensive purpose. Defensive purpose is known as white hat hackers. White hat hackers are usually security professionals with knowledge of hacking, and the hackers toolset and who use the knowledge to locate weakness and implement the countermeasures. Normally, white hat hackers are very good guys. It means they have a hacking knowledge, but they are never be harmful to the system. Then you go for the black hats. Black hats are the bad guys in ethical hacking concept. The malicious hackers or crackers who use their skills for illegal or malicious purpose. They break into or otherwise violate the system integrity of remote systems with malicious intent. This is the main role of the black hat hackers. Having gained unauthorized access, black hat hackers destroy vital data, deny legitimate user service, and just cause a problem of their targets. These are the main role of the black hat hackers. Black hat hackers and crackers can easily be differentiated from the white hat hackers because their actions are malicious. This is the traditional definition of a hacker. Hacker means, this is the basic difference between a white hat and black hat. Then you go for the gray hat hackers. Gray hat are hackers who may work offensively or defensive. Either they go for an offensive approach or defensive approach, depending on the situation. This is the dividing line between the hackers and the crackers. Gray hat hackers may just be interested in hacking tools and techniques, are not malicious black hats, are not like malicious black hats. Gray hat are self-proclaimed ethical hackers who are interested in hacking of tools only. This is the type of gray hat hackers. Then we go for suicide hackers. Individuals who will aim to bring down the critical infrastructure, whatever be the consequence may be, is known as suicide hackers. Then script kiddies. In a hacker culture, a script kiddies or skiddies are unskilled individuals who use script or programs developed by others to attack computer systems and networks and deface websites. It is generally assumed that script kiddies are juveniles who lack of ability to write sophisticated hacking programs or exploit to other ones. Their objective is to gain the credit of the computer to adjust the system. Their main aim is to typically intended as the insult, to insult the behavior of the system. This is known as the script kiddies. Then the hacktivist dictates and sometimes reports or exploits security vulnerability as a form of social activist. A hacktivist is a hacker who utilizes technologies to announce a social, ideological, religious, or political message. In general, most activists involve defacement or denial of service attacks. This is also known as a new attacker. Activist means this is otherwise known as a new attacker. Now, normally in penetration testing, normally people are always testing for gathering some type of information for their use. It means they are gathering IP addresses. For example, if you know the IP address, you can check also the whether the IP is in DHCP or in static mode. It can be also be checked. IP addresses, namespace, employee information, phone numbers, facility information, job information. Normally, these are the information can cast by the hackers by passive vigilance methods. In case of active vigilance methods, the hackers scan networks scanning and the vulnerability scanning. They are using some tools for scanning the network scanning. They are pings, they are establishing pings, ping sweeps, port scans, and trace active. Normally, pings are very much useful for hacking up websites. It means if you know some URL, then it can also, by the method of ping, you can also pass to your server also. And the time required to establish the pings also, it can be masked. Hackers are seeking any information that can helpful to penetrate an attack. These are the IP address. It means IP address for open and closed ports, host ports, information on the operating system, system architectures, then the service or process running on the host. These are the main things required for hackers before processing any hacking logic. Then hackers must be known for the emulation. This is the last phase before you attempt the gain access to the system is the enumeration phase. Enumeration is the systematic probing of the target. The goal of obtaining the list of routing tables, protocols, these are the main target by the hackers to get it. By doing enumeration, the following steps are required by the hackers. This might exact usernames using enumeration, group information, passwords, hidden shares, and device information, network layouts must be known by the hackers, protocol information, server data, service information, gather information about the host using null sessions, perform Windows enumeration using SuperScan tools, acquire user accounts using different data tools, protect SNMP or protocol scanning is also known by the hackers before doing any hacking. This is known as enumeration. Then we go for the password cracking techniques. Different password cracking techniques are available. Before getting access, you must know how to crack the passwords by the different users. Normally, there are several techniques that are available. One is dictionary attack. Dictionary attack means if you guess some passwords by the help of some enumerated data, then you go for the dictionary attack. Suppose you are getting first letter P and second letter R. In between, there are two hash functions are there. Then you check for dictionary for the four character letters. The dictionary attack means in an attack of this type takes in the form of a password cracking application that has a dictionary file loaded into it. The dictionary file is a text file that contains a list of known words and including the entire dictionary. The application uses that list to test different words in an attempt to recover the password. System that use dictionary words typically are not vulnerable to this type of attack. If you are not using any dictionary words, suppose alphanumeric words you are using, means dictionary attack is not possible. Then the second category of attack is brute force attack. In this type of attack, every possible combination of characters is attempted until the correct one is unreachable. It means, suppose for example, if we get a debit card of a particular person, if you know the debit card pin is a 4-digit number, then you go for writing a script which will create a lot of 4-digit number based on the digits in between 0 to 9. It means you can check for the 90,000 times in between one value must be accepted. This is known as a brute force attack. in this type of attack, every possible combination of character is attempted until the correct one is uncovered. According to the RSA Labs, exhaustive key search, brute force search is the basic technique for trying every possible key in terms of until the correct key is identified. Based on the brute force attacks, normally banks are using, after giving two to three unmatched pin, the card will be blocked for one day. It means when the card is lost means when the attacker can attack only two to three passwords at one day only. This is an example of brute force attack. Now then we go for the hybrid attack. This form of password attack builds on the dictionary attack with the additional step as the top part of the process. In most cases, this means passwords that are tried during a dictionary attack are modified with the addition or subtraction of special characters and numbers, such as for example, password. Password is written, A is modified with the @ value. Suppose O is modified with 0 value. In such situation, this can be checked. This is known as hybrid attack. Then we go for the syllable attack. This type of attack is a combination of brute force and dictionary attack. This is known as a syllable attack. It is useful when the password a user has chosen is not standard word or phrases. This is only possible in case of syllable attacks. Then you go for the rule-based attack. This could be considered as an advanced attack. It assumes that the user has created a password using information of the attackers as some knowledge, or ahead of time, such phrases and the digits the users may have a tendency to use. For example, every people has a tendency to use their date of birth, year of birth as a symbols. It should be used by the attackers also. This is known as a symbolic attack. Then you go for passive online attack. Attacks in which category are carried out simply by sitting back and listening in this case by technology in the form of sniffing tools such as Wirestrike, man-in-middle attack or relay attacks. These are known as the passive online attacks. Then active online attacks. The attacks this category are more aggressive than passive attacks because the process requires deep engagement. It means you have to target the browsers, you have to approach the passwords. Active attacks are very effective form of the active online attacks. Trojans, spyware, key lockers, these harsh injections and phishing are also helpful for active online attacks. Then you go for the offline attacks. This type of attack is designed to prey on the weakness not of passwords, but of the way they are stored. Because passwords must be stored in some formats, an attacker seeks to obtain them when they are stored by exploiting poor security or weaknesses inherent in a system. If these credentials happen to be stored in a plain text, this is known as or encrypted format, the attacker will go after this file and gain the credentials. It is known as offline attacks. This is normally established by the help of a pre-computed hash function. Pre-computed hashes or distributed network attack. And rainbow attacks is also used in offline attacks. Then non-technical attacks. Non-technical attacks, this is otherwise known as non-electrical attacks, electronic attacks. This moves the process of offline into the real world. The characteristics of this attack is that it requires any technical knowledge, that does not require any technical knowledge, and instead relies on theft. Forms of attacker includes sorting, social engineering, dumpster driving. This is also known as non-technical attacks. These are the mainly used for password cracking techniques. I can summarize. Normally, password cracking techniques are of 9 types in industry right now: dictionary attacks, brute force attacks, hybrid attacks, syllable attacks, rule based attacks, passive online attacks, active online attacks, offline attacks, and non-technical attacks. Is there any doubt, sir? Sir?
Yes, sir. We will ask at the end of the session. All questions will ask at the end. Yes, sir.
Sir,
we'll ask at the end of the session, sir. Okay. So
sir?
You should continue. You should continue. We will ask later.
Okay.
Sir, for session sorla pore ame pocharibu. Ebe apan continue karantu. How? Thik.
Then we go for the cyber crime. This is the cyber crime. Cyber crime means the crime done by two different ways. One is computer based crime, and another one is computer facilitated crime. These two types of crimes are known as cyber crimes. Computer based crime means this is a criminal activity that can be conducted poorly on computers. For example, cyber crimes by the help of spams, as well as crimes newly defined by the computing ages. This is known as purely based on the cyber crime. Computer facilitated crime means crimes conducted in the real world but facilitated by the use of computers. A classical example of this computer based facilitated crime is fraud. Frauds, normally computers are commonly used to communicate to other fraudsters to record or plan activities to create fraudulent documents. This is known as comes under computer facilitated crime. These two types of crimes are mainly based on cyber crimes. Well, what are the strategies for computer forensic process? Using computer forensic, overall computer forensic processes are consist of four stages. One is acquire, analyze, evaluate, and present. These are the four steps normally used for computer forensic process. Acquire means identify and preserving is the main mode of acquire. Analyze means technical analysis by default, details evaluation is known as the analysis. Then evaluate. But what are the laws behind it, or what are the cyber rules behind it? This known as what is the process of evaluation by the help of laws. Then we go for the present computer evidence in manner that legally acceptable to any legal proceedings known as present. These are the four procedures, the four steps normally used in computer forensic processes. As everybody knows, what is the computer uses of computer forensic means intellectual property thefts, industrial plannings, must be staged, employment disputes, fraud investigations. regulatory compliances, this must be checked by the computer forensics. What is the objective? Then we discuss the objective of computer forensics. The main basic objective is to check the victims, by handle the victims first. These are the steps. First, responder producers and access the victim's computers after incidents. This is the first step. Designing procedures at a suspected crime to ensure that the digital evidence obtained is not corrupted. It means recovering details, deleted files and deleted partitions from the digital media to extract the evidence from the and to validate them. These are the process by objective of the computer forensics. Preserving the evidence by following the chain of custody, presenting computer forensic results in a court of law and expect witnesses. These are the main objective of computer forensics. What are the rules or roles of computer forensic investigator? Confirm the displays, whether the resource or network is consist or not. Determine extent of damage due to intrudence. Answers of the questions are who, what, when, where, how, why. These are also useful for while investigating the role of computer forensics. Then you go for the what are the steps required for forensic readiness planning. Going for any planning, forensic planning, you must determine the business scenario that requires digital evidence, identify available source and different type of potential evidence, determine the evidence collection requirements, establish a capability for securing, gathering illegal admissible and evidence to meet the requirements. This is the main problem. Establish a policy for secure storage and handling of potential evidence, ensuring monitoring targeted to detect major evidences, specific document an evidence-based case describing the incident and its impact, ensure legal reviews, facilitate actions in response and evidence. These are the main readiness before going for a forensic plan. Possible evidence sources must be included with the planning. Who are the data, where the data is generated, what format is it in, how long it will store for, who is currently controlled or secured and managed, how, who has accessed the data, how much is produced, how much is reviewed, who is responsible for the data. These are the mainly questions that comes under while planning for the forensic readiness. Sir, this is the main work of security management.
Okay, sir.
Sir.
So, so question session start for you. Sir, can we start the question session?
Okay, sir.
Question answer session? Okay. Okay, thank you, sir, for a nice session, great session. So, student have asked some questions.
Sir.
I will read out one by one.
Okay.
So first question is, what is the difference between digital signature and electronic signature?
In case of digital signature are little bit different. Electronic signatures are created by many real activities. It means the real situations are live situations. It means you have given some OTP, you have given some any other validation document. Suppose, for example, in case of electronic signature, you have to authorize some unique information. It means like your PAN number is authorized, like your mobile number is authorized. It is normally done in electronic signature. In digital signature, only one, simply along with your details, only one real application is included. Both the creation way is same. Digital signature and electronic signature, both the creation way is same, but the real-time applications are different.
Okay, sir. Next question, sir. Can I do pen testing practically?
Pen testing practically. This is a way also, while hackers are doing pen testing practical way, some team of hackers, they are using some SQL injection by the help of pen testing. It means they have asked a question to the database. It may suppose their everybody's account balance is floated in the cloud. It means your account balance is also known by the Visa, Rupee. Every third party is also known your account balance. You know, suppose some hackers can create a queries where the your account balance is greater than 4 digit but less than 6 digit.
Okay,
sir. To phase the information. Some public information are phased by the hackers. This is one example of penetration testing.
Okay, sir. Next question is, please explain shoulder surfing and dumpster diving.
Sir, again the question, sir.
Shoulder surfing and dumpster diving.
These are the practical.
These are the mainly two
type of pen testing. Dumpster diving means you do not have any knowledge regarding the resource. Only you have to check if there any vulnerability is accessed or gained by you. This is known as the dumpster diving process. But it is a continuous process. You do not know the code inside details. Only you have to browse and check for the details.
Okay, sir. Next question, sir. What is the success rate to escape from a penetrator system without getting recognized during the reconsciousness?
Success rate is less than 1%. Every websites are now SSL certified. If the website is not SSL certified, means there no hidden works can be done. No security is accepted. The success rate is less than 1%.
Less than 1%, okay. Yes. Sir, penetration test, pen testing, टिके explain करके बताइए।
हाँ sir, actually कौन सी जिन्हें हमें IT industry में गोटे कौन करा जाए, data जिनसे testing करा जाए, penetration बड़ा, गोटे उनकी statistical testing और उनकी mutation testing. Statistical testing कौन करा जाए? Normally गोटे database अच्छी, गोटे database रे, तो गोटे bank रो database अच्छी, जो उतरे कि 12 digit रो number exist करी, तले 13 digit number ले कौन होगा? Whether the number is being chopped or the database will be crashed. These are the two processes. Suppose you are entering a 13 digit number, means what will be happen to the database? This is done by the statistical testing. Pen testing is only used to check the security levels of the database. This is the main role of the pen testers. Pen testers always check the vulnerability present in the system. There are several. They can SQL injection is also known as snipping. All are the example of pen testing. While pen testing means they can always fire some queries to the database to extract some unuseful things for the purpose of usefulness. It means gote local thara apan gote social website ru thara email address pai gale, date of birth pai gale, thara naam pai gale. Kintu apan dekhile je gote credit card information re se naam ta match kari jauchi. किंतु क्रेडिट कार्ड इनफॉरमेशन जो 16 डिजिट अच्छी ओनली 4 डिजिट आर एक्सेसिबल अदर 12 डिजिट आर पुटेड बाय द हैश मार्क तो आपण कोंगले इन इट दिस इज एग्जांपल ऑफ अ पेन टेस्टिंग रियल वर्ल्ड एग्जांपल आपण कोंगले ताको कोंगले सोशल एक्टिविस्ट आपण को फोन नंबर यूज करले फोन रे आपण चाहिबे जे गेन करिया पई और मिडिल 8 डिजिट कारण फर्स्ट 8 इज बेस्ड ऑन द रीजन बेस्ड इफ इट बिलोंग्स टू ओडिसा मींस द फर्स्ट 4 डिजिट इज फिक्स्ड फॉर ऑल यूजर्स बेस्ड ऑन द ईयर कोड आपण लास्ट हां मिडिल चैप्टर डिजिट जे आपण पाई गेले तो पेन टेस्टिंग सक्सेसफुल हो
ओके सो हिमाद्री सर
हिमाद्री सर सर हां
मो जस्ट टिके सुधीर सर को
हां सर हां सर
सुधीर सर एवं हिमाद्री सर एवं ऑल लर्नर्स
सर
आपण माने खुशी हेबे आमो साथरे जणे अछंती लर्नर जे की रामचंद्र पृष्टि
सर
सर लर्नर एवं जे हाई स्कूल टीचर सीनियर फैकल्टी साइंस एंड मैथमेटिक्स टीचर तो पृष्टि सर कौन पचारियाकु चाहुचंती पचारि
परंती सर सर आउतर मीनिंग ऑफ
क्रिप्टोग्राफिक वैल्यू सर
हाउ यूज इन रियल लाइफ सिचुएशन बाय
सी आर वाई पी टी वाई पी आर ए टी एच आई सी क्रिप्टोग्राफिक
वैल्यू सर सी आर
सी आर सी
CRY
हाँ क्रिप्टोग्राफिक वैल्यू हाँ क्रिप्टोग्राफिक वैल्यू क्रिप्टोग्राफिक वैल्यू हाँ नॉर्मली इन केस ऑफ क्रिप्टोग्राफी मीन सपोज यू आर सेंडिंग हेलो द ओरिजिनल मीनिंग ऑफ हेलो इज डिफरेंट इन क्रिप्टोग्राफी इट इज बीन कोडेड बाय सर्टेन रूल्स दिस इज यूज्ड इन क्रिप्टोग्राफिक वैल्यू जमी आम आगुरी पुराण काल सर मुझे एग्जांपल कहूँ आम जमी पुराण काल राजा मैंने पारागढ़ में चिठी देते चिठीटा ओरिजिनल चिठी नाला कारण पर्टिकुलर जो से राजा पाखे पहुंच से राजा से इंस्ट्रक्शन टाक बुझी पारे से सिस्टम ऑफ क्रिप्ट क्रिप्टोग्राफी क्रिएट होने आपड़ जानते गार मु पकईदे मोर जी पर्टिकुलर रिसीवर सी बुझी पार गार मीनिंग कौन मैंने कौ दिग्वर कौ सैन्य कौपटे आसुच्च राजा बुझी पारे बाय द इनफर्म ऑफ सम सिंबल्स कौन जगह लस हुए भी कहीं नो बड़ी विल एनकैश दिस दिस इज द रोल ऑफ क्रिप्टोग्राफी क्रिप्टोग्राफी कौन हो ओरिजिनल मेसेज शुड बी एम्बेडेड बाय सम रूल्स बाय द हेल्प ऑफ क्रिप्टोग्राफी फंक्शन इनिशियली कीटा आपन पाको पड़ी जाउछ जेतोल आपन से मेसेज पाइबे दिस ओरिजिनल मेसेज विल बी कन्वर्टेड टू दिस इज नो बेसिक रूल ऑफ क्रिप्टोग्राफी
ओके ओके गुड बहुत सुंदर भाबरे सुदेश सर आपन डिस्क्रिप्शन करले मो बाबू छी रामचंद्र सर निश्चित भाबरे बुझि पारिथिबे
यस सर
गुड गुड बहुत बढ़िया हला नाउ Sir is continuing approximately 60 years.
Sir, sir,
Fakir Fakir Mohan Autonomous College re se achanti learner. Bahut samay mo sathe misanti. Very good gentleman. Okay, thank you, sir. Okay.
Thank you.
Sir, next question asiji. Huh?
Sir,
public key, private key. How used in a real life situation by sender and by receiver.
Receiver.
How the public keys are made available to receiver. And sender respectively mane public ki private ki real use kemiti aare
पब्लिक की प्राइवेट के होची कोन जतरा में कोन सोडे डाटा पठू छे मीडियम रे जेतु डाटा लॉस न होय पई हमें की एस्टैब्लिश करा जाय माने रियल डाटा डा मीडियम रे केमती लॉस न होबो ता पई के हमें की एस्टैब्लिश करा जाय बाय द यूज सम एल्गोरिथम्स आपण एल्गोरिथम रे आपण कोन कले ओडे की करके तको हास फंक्शन कले कोन ये डाटा रे ओडे वेट गेन करा जाय मैंने पर्टिकुलर एत केबीपीएस टाक आ कम करें डाटा टाक सेंड कले बाय थ्रू चैनल्स बिफोर सेंडिंग द डाटा द की वैल्यू शुड बी सेंड टू द सेंडर सेंडर पाखे की वैल्यू थी कौन हम डाटा पहुंचला डाटा टा डिक्रिप्ट हो पार देन द सेंडर विल बी गेट द ओरिजिनल डाटा इन बिटवीन जो मैंने हाकर्स रे डाटा टाक पढ़ी पारे कौन पाखे की वैल्यू ना इफ द की वैल्यू इज अवेलेबल टू द अटैकर मीन The data is being lost. Seta hunchi public key, private key ra concept. Kan channel re ame original information share kari parne. Channel re ame itle information share korche, taku encrypted format re share korche. Tan encrypted format ta decrypt hoba pai key value darkar hunchi. Apan pan jo ta jo key ta apan create korchhan, tanko pan seta hunchi private key. To particular sender pai this is the private key.
सर डिजिटल सर्टिफिकेट टिके एक्सप्लेन कर दे डिजिटल सर्टिफिकेट व्हाट इज डिजिटल सर्टिफिकेट
हां डिजिटल सर्टिफिकेट रे मेन होची आमे ऑथेंटिकेट करछे एबे देखछंती आपण देखियो जेतोले आधार नंबर को आपण डाउनलोड करछंती आधार नंबर उले आस सम ओटीपी कारण जेतु ओटे पीडीएफ फॉर्मेट रे अच्छी ताको ओटे ओटीपी लॉकर तरह लॉक कराय छे ओटीपी कोथरे आछु वेदर दिस ओटीपी योर कम्स अंडर योर फोन नंबर और अदरवाइज योर डिफॉल्ट डेट ऑफ बर्थ और पिन कोड दीज आर द इंफॉर्मेशंस must be matched it means the user must know his date of birth must know his pin code must know his mobile numbers this is known as the digital certificate the original certificate is encrypted in a certain format to get the particular user only if by access on real media the digital certificate main meaning hunchi abe jota kara hunchi by the way jemti apan dekhsuni nic gote digital certificate use korchi resident certificate income certificate ei purpose digital certificate use karanchi तमने अपन कोन कले यू हैव टू माने एप्लीकेशन देले गुडे कॉमन सीएससी सेंटर रे सीएससी सेंटर्स आर माने एस्टैब्लिश्ड टू चेक योर इंफॉर्मेशन ओरिजिनल इंफॉर्मेशन ओनली से ओरिजिनल इंफॉर्मेशन को एन्क्रिप्ट करके चेक कोला अटैच कर देला देन द ऑथराइजर पर्संस योर आरआई योर तहसीलदार दे आर यूजिंग देयर एन्क्रिप्टेड फॉर्मेट आफ्टर देयर ऑथराइजेशन इज ओवर यू विल गेट योर सर्टिफिकेट बैक दिस इज द टोटल प्रोसेस ऑफ क्रिएटिंग डिजिटल सर्टिफिकेट
Okay. Yeah, Mr. Senapati, in this context, the class 1, 2 and 3, what is the difference in the security levels in these three classes?
Haan.
And the real application where these three are differently used?
ओके ओके इन केस ऑफ क्लास वन ओनली वन 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 ऑथेंटिकेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड ओटीपी ओटीपी इज कम्स अंडर क्लास वन व्हाइल यू आर यूजिंग इन ड्राइविंग लाइसेंस द एनक्रिप्टेड स्क्रिप्ट इज मैच्ड विथ योर लाइक ए जीप द जीप इंफॉर्मेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड इन दिस इन केस ऑफ क्लास टू मीन्स मोर देन वन रियल टाइम एप्लीकेशन आर नीडेड योर फेस मार्क योर फोटोग्राफ योर थंब इंप्रेशन In all these things, all these real applications are encrypted in class 2-3 format. Only in case of class 1, only one real-time application is encrypted. This is a standard. This is a standard of classification. This is provided by the US IT 2000 rules only.
And what about class 3, sir?
Class 3, in banking transactions, they are using three four-step applications. It means while you are taking right now loan on phone. Loan on phone is one example of class 3 application. You do not go to the bank. You can by giving a phone call. You can also accept the loan. It means they can ask you several questions. Real time application. The real time application must be matched within the real time information. It means your OTP must be matched with a 30 second duration only. Comes across more than 30 seconds, it means your OTP is manipulated somewhere else. The bank will be thinking that. Class 3 application means more than 2 to 3 applications are integrated to authenticate the users only. This is normally done in credit card application, loan in phone applications, or comes under class 3 applications.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Anyone, any question, you can unmute your mic and there is another question.
Yeah, Mr. Senapati, what is the best techniques adopted by the best organization across the world to prevent password thefts effectively? What are the techniques?
Organization password theft very difficult, very difficult. I'm a patre porche, it was a situation. In the organization, it is difficult means or every organization, they are using firewalls. Firewalls main aim is to check the inbound and outbound traffic. Firewalls normally firewall means it is a in Odia this is like a gorokhai. Raja mane tankara ghar chari pakare gorokhai kortule. Ta mane sen kon kortule pani ra gote canal kortule. Tenu konosi loko taku paare ke asparibuni. Before coming it must be checked. Like that firewall works. Mane niara gote jemti chari pakare jako jouti dekhibo organization achi mane. Every organization must using firewalls. Firewall means the entire server information is saved by layer 2, layer 3, layer 4 security also present. While you are using firewalls, nobody needs to hack it. In some situation, if you are एबे जेंती डेक्शन मैक्सिमम जगह एटीएम फ्रॉड्स होस दिस इज अ नोन फ्रॉड्स त माने से लोक किछि इन्फॉर्मेशन आपन को जानि छि से एटीएम फ्रॉड को इन फायरल एप्लीकेशन थिले आपन को कोनसे अपने ई सब इन काम प्रोसेस किछि हेल्पफुल हे परे नॉर्मली इंडस्ट्री सर सर
सर कंटिन्यू
हां सर लास्ट आगुडे क्वेश्चन आसी जी
हां सर पछ हां क्रिप्टोग्राफी की को केमिति हमें टेस्ट करबा आतर एफिशिएंसी केमिति एस्टीमेट करबा
हां क्रिप्टोग्राफी
क्रिप्टो हां हाउ एस्टीमेट द क्रिप्टोग्राफी की
क्रिप्टोग्राफी क्रिएट की होची आपन पे गो एल्गोरिथम यू हैव टू फर्स्ट एस्टैब्लिश द एल्गोरिथम हां देन हां एल्गोरिथम एस्टैब्लिश करे पड़े आपन केते की वैल्यूज लेबे आपन दर कहबे जे मु स्मॉल लेटर्स ओनली लेबी तले की वैल्यू हो 26 आपन यदि कहबे स्मॉल लेटर अलोंग विथ कैपिटल लेटर लेबी तले की वैल्यू जबो 52 तनु मॉड रेशियो एस्टैब्लिश कर फॉर एग्जांपल आपन यदि कहबे ओटे एटीएम पिन ता 4 डिजिट नंबर तले ओटे 4 डिजिट ता गेस करबा बहुत सहज हो माने 10000 थर यदि आपन गेस करछन त वन टाइम जेंटले सक्सेस हो फॉर दैट रीजन बैंक कोन करछि तीनटा गेस पर आपन को कार्ड ता को ब्लॉक करछि एकदम क्रिप्टोग्राफी की वैल्यूज आपन जते यूज करबे से अनुसार क्रिप्टोग्राफी की ता एनहांसमेंट हो एबे क्रिप्टोग्राफी लॉजिक बिकम डिफरेंट दे आर यूजिंग डिफरेंट की वैल्यूज Like जो आंसर है जिनके अपनों 256 characters अच्छी all 256 characters along with face mark, iris, eye, thumb impressions are also used in cryptography encryptions. It is very difficult to crack a cryptography information.
ओके सर आगे गोटे कौन क्वेश्चन है जी रे
Yeah, Mr. Senapati, a small request. In the last class also and in today's class, we have been requesting for a PPT presentation, which I feel would greatly help us to focus. And based on your experience, we will still once again request, kindly provide us as quickly as possible. Because apna aaj padhele, apna unless we go through that thing, seta recapitulate hobo nahi. So kindly, the sincere request, kindly provide for the last class. And for the today's class also.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Add करी भी किसी मैंने learner request करी चंती PPT पाएं. PPT तो सर देवे. तास वही तो मुँह कोई देवे. जहाँ को भी जहाँ पाको को भी तुम्हारे study material जाई नहीं. Study material हमारे already OSU site रे अच्छी soft copy. Study material are already available in website. So please check it and before class please go through the study material. So it will be easy for you. So sir. Last question, only one last question, that is algorithm for cryptography key. I think you go for the network security, right?
Haan, sir. Deeper mod logical is also known by the user.
Algorithm
for cryptography key. RSA, DSA algorithm, click for it.
Thank you, sir, for a great session.
Sir. Thank you, sir.
And thank you, learner. To participate in this session, it's a great session, and I will appreciate, sir, to complete all this topic in a time-bound session. Thank you all. So now I request Bhavesh sir to conclude our session now.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Sudhir sir.
Thank you.
Himadri sir, and all learners. Now our time is over. We are. Now close this session.
Okay. We'll meet next time.
Good afternoon, all.
Good afternoon.